Hi, here in this video, we are going to see how we can use ModelViewSet to create RESTful web services using Django. I am opening PyCharm here. Create new project. Creating the project. Now we have to install Django. Open the terminal and create a Django project. For that, we need to execute command pip install Django. Django is installed successfully. Now install pip install Django REST framework. Now we have installed Django and Django REST framework. We should see those libraries here. Yes, it has got installed. Now create a Django project. For that, we need to execute the command Django hyphen admin start project. Naming the project as ViewSet API. Now we can see a folder named ViewSet API created here. Now let's start the Django web server to see the things are working fine or not. Go to CD, ViewSet API. Type dir command to check whether there is a managed py in that particular folder. Yes, there is a managed.py. Now we can execute the command python manage py run server. Now Django development server is running at port 8000. Click on that. Now we got the default Django page. Now installation is okay. Control C. Now let's create a Django app. For that, execute the command python manage py start app. Name of the app. I'm going to mention this as address. Now we have created a address app here. Inside this particular app or module, we are going to develop REST APIs for managing address information. In the model.py, I'm going to create an address model. Here I am providing the required attribute for the address. So this is the model class. Now we want to create the table structure for this particular model. For that, we can execute command python manage py make migrations. So it is saying that no changes detected. The reason is that once we create a Django app, that has to be listed here in settings.py. The installed apps properties we need to mention address. Now let's execute this particular command again. Now we got this particular script generated inside this particular migration folder. Now we can create the table in the database using migrate command. Execute python manage py migrate to create the table. we have created the table in this particular SQLite database. Now let's create the serializer for this particular model class. Create a new file, right click, new Python file. We need to import model serializer from REST framework dot serializers. Import model serializer from dot models. Import address model. Create a class address serializer by inheriting model serializer. Create a meta class inside this class meta. Here we need to specify the model to be serialized. Address is our model. Then what are the fields from this particular model to be serialized by this particular model serializer? So we need to mention fields underscore underscore all underscore underscore. That means all the fields get serialized by this particular model serializer. So now we have created the serializer. The purpose of serializer is to convert from the incoming JSON data to Python object and Python object to JSON format. Now we are going to create the view. We need to import from REST framework dot view set. Import model view set from models. Import address model from serializer. Import address serializer. Create a class. I'm creating a class named address view by inheriting model view set, naming it as view set. We can name whatever name you like. Here this is important, model view set. And here we need to provide couple of information. One is serializer class equal to address serializer and query set equal to address model dot objects dot all. Django already created a model view set class that provides CRUD operations on this particular model. We have provided how to query the model and how to serialize the model to the model view set. Model view set already has mixins created for creating, retrieving, updating, destroying, and listing. The default implementation is already there, but if you want to customize the create, update, delete operations, we can override these particular functions in our view class. So we are going with the default implementation of view set. Next, we need to map this particular view set functions to URL. For that, I'm going to create a new Python file. I'm creating a URLs. REST framework import from REST framework dot routers. Import, I'm going with the default router using which we can create URLs for the model view set. Here I'm creating an object for the router. We need to register the model view set to the router. For that, we need to import from dot views. Import address view set. Router dot register. We need to provide a prefix. I'm providing slash address. And here we need to provide the view set name, providing the view set as address view set. Then here we can create a URL patterns array, URL pattern list. We can define the path. We need to get the URLs provided by this
router to this particular URL pattern list. For that, we need to use a couple of functions. Import path, comma, include. Here we have to provide path. The path I am providing some path here, and include routers.urls. So router provides a list of URLs that we are adding to this particular path. This particular URL patterns array has to be included in the main application, that is this thing. And here we need to provide path. So what should be the path? I'm providing anything here, comma, and include. Here we can provide the name of the app, that is address. Then dot, what is the file name or module name? URLs. Now run it. Run the application. Now run the Django server, Python manage per run server. So here we have an API link also, admin and API link, / API / So it is saying that template does not exist, / API. Some error here, right? Okay, I think let's check one thing. Go to the settings.py. settings.py. In the installed apps, okay, in the installed apps we need to provide REST framework. Mention REST _ framework / API. Now we got Django REST framework web page to test the API. But here we are seeing two slashes. Save it. Click on this again. / API. So click on this particular address API. Post. So the data get posted. We post one more. Post. Now we got that particular data got posted. If you click on get, we can see all the object. We can use tools like Postman to manage things better. Search Postman download in Google. So here we can see a link, postman.com.download. Click on that. Download. I'm using Windows 64-bit. Now download is complete. Open. Now we are going to test this particular thing using Postman. Copy this. Sent. We are making HTTP GET request to this particular URL. So we are getting this couple of record which we have created. And if you want to get a specific one, we can provide. And if you want to post, just copy this content, This is the JSON object to be posted. So click on post. And here in this body, click on draw. This is a JSON payload. So we need to mention JSON. And so here no need to send this particular ID. Providing some value as a JSON object and sending this particular data as a post request. Send it. Now we got an internal server error. Okay, send it. And one more thing is that we need to provide a slash here. Post. Now we got the response. Okay. It's a status 201, that means created. Okay. Now if you provide get, we should get the 3 addresses. So we are getting 3 addresses here. And if you want to edit a particular address, we have to use put. I want to edit the address, the first address with something, or third address with a different phone number. So we have to provide just send. So we are creating a put request to the. So one more thing is that here we have to provide a slash. Here we need to provide the ID which we are updating and provide a slash at the end. So click send. Now we got the response. So we have updated the phone number to 123 up to 9. And just check get sent. So now we got the phone number for that. So the update got updated in the database. Now, if you want to delete a particular record, here we need to provide what address ID we need to delete. And here we can provide HTTP delete. Is sent. So that content got deleted and we got the status code as 204, no content. Now if you want to do partial update, so I'm going to get the content of address slash one slash get. So we got it, got this particular content. I want to change the phone number of this particular address object. So either I can use if you're passing the entire content, you can use put. If you're passing only a section of address, we can use patch phone number. And here I'm not sending the entire content, only the specific field. And here I'm mentioning currently this is the content. Here I'm changing to, here I'm changing the content to this particular value and click on send. So it's got patched. So the remaining information is also there. And if you simply get it, we should get that. Okay. So that is the purpose of patch. I hope you got some idea about how to do CRUD operation using ViewSet API. Thank you for watching this.